Hey guys, it's Justin, and today I'm visiting the Changgyeong Palace in Seoul. In my opinion, the most underrated of the five grand palaces in Seoul has to be the Changgyeong Palace. The palace as it is known today was built in 1418 by King Sejong for his father, and was often used as a secondary residential palace for the queen. While most other palaces were built under the strict rules of a north-to-south orientation, Changgyeong features a more liberal design with an east-to-west orientation, which actually has a huge impact on the overall feeling of the grounds here. Admission to the palace and all of its grounds only costs 1,000 won, and the palace is open every day except for Mondays, with the opening and closing times varying by seasons. The overall layout here feels much more spaced out and yet somehow more personal when compared to the other grand palaces. It also shares an adjoining gate with Changgyeong Palace, which can be entered for an additional 3,000 won, and the hill leading up this gate offers a spectacular view of Changgyeonggung from above. Additionally, one of my favorite aspects of this palace is the sprawling walking path throughout the grounds. The nature here is what truly sets this palace apart for me, as the grounds can be explored freely and without any extra charge, unlike the secret gardens of Changgyeonggung Palace. Also, there's generally much smaller crowds here when compared to the more famous Gyeongbok Palace, which gives Changgyeonggung a much more calm and peaceful atmosphere. This is a perfect place to see or take pictures of the beautiful blossoms of spring or the stunning foliage of autumn, especially around the picturesque Chundongji Pond, which sits at the north end of the grounds. There are also guided tours here which take around an hour to complete and are offered in languages such as English, Chinese, and Japanese. The final aspect that really helps this palace stand out as unique is the Daeonshu, or the Great Glass Greenhouse. This Victorian-style greenhouse was built in 1909 and is based on the design of the Crystal Palace in London, England. Inside, you will find many rare plants indigenous to Korea, as well as plants from around the world. Outside, the greenhouse courtyard features a labyrinth-style garden as well as a Renaissance-style fountain. If you are visiting Seoul and are looking for a more calming and nature-driven palace experience, then Changgyeong Palace is a great choice. If you've been to Changgyeong Palace before or plan to go in the future, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Make sure to hit the like and subscribe buttons to get some weekly Korean and travel videos, and thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time.